Honorable Minister, IPCC Vice Chair, Dr. Sharma Oli, IPCC Working Group Second, which is Director General of this board, distinguished scientists, media friends, ladies and gentlemen, a very, very good morning and very, very warm welcome to Nepal to all foreign delegates. Indeed, it is my great pleasure to be here with you, and I extend a warm welcome to all of you. I express my sincere gratitude to the IPCC Secretariat and IPCC Working Group Second for organizing this important event for the first time in Nepal. Similarly, my sincere thanks goes to the Ministry of Forest and Environment and Institute for organizing and hosting the event and inviting me as the chief guest to address this August gathering of IPCC others. Ladies and gentlemen, our country Nepal is a landlocked and mountainous country with diverse ethnicities and cultures, rich biological diversity, and incredibly beautiful landscape. People from all over the world come to enjoy this natural and cultural beauty, not only as tourists, but also as researchers. I presume that this may have influenced the IPCC's decision to organize this important event here in Kathmandu. On a more serious note, Nepal is also extremely vulnerable to the adverse effect of climate change. While our contribution to global greenhouse gas emission is insignificant, rising temperatures, retreating glaciers and erratic rainfall are having a serious and negative impact on our citizens, damaging farms, homes and infrastructure, and causing huge losses to the economy. We have no choice but to be prepared to address these impacts and make our people more resilient to climate change. We promulgated our new constitution in 2015. Article 30 gives citizens the fundamental right to a clean environment. Tragically, there was a massive earthquake in the same year. Thousands of people lost their lives and properties, with millions was damaged every year. Government invests huge amount of resources for disaster management. Particularly to rescue and rehabilitate people from landslides and floods in the summer and monsoon months. Recent times show that the weather is becoming more unpredictable and there are new risks as we witness delayed monsoon this year, as my dear friend just mentioned before. According to the Struck Para and Parsa districts in the south, for the first time in our recorded history, killing 32 and destroying property worth millions. While there is no sector that is unaffected by climate change, the agriculture sector is the most affected, aggravating flood and nutritional Similarly, forest and biodiversity, energy and water resources, tourism, urban and rural settlements, industry and infrastructure sector are all negatively impacted by climate change. Together, they have a huge direct and negative impact on the national economy. The government has a vision of prosperous Nepal, happy Nepali, which we believe can be achieved through green economy pathways and low carbon strategy while carrying out industrial infrastructure and urban and rural development. Ladies and gentlemen, in our pursuit of rapid industrial infrastructure and economic growth, we humans are ignoring all other life forms. As a result of this rapid economic and industrial development, the adverse effects of climate change are constantly increasing. To some extent also, working as a barrier to peace building and security and causing imbalances in natural and human systems. I am fully aware of the IPCC's special report on global warming of 1.5 degrees Celsius, released last year, and its recommendations concerning 1.5 and 2 degrees Celsius pathways. I am pleased to let you know that the government is going to approve a new climate change policy 2019 very soon, considering the IPCC's recommendations. Fellow scientists, science is not negotiative. I reiterate that Nepal wholeheartedly welcomes the IPCC's 1.5 degrees Celsius report, although the findings are very alarming. Following our standing COP24, made by our right honorable president and the commitments made by our delegates to the 50th session to the subsidiary body of scientific and technological advice last month in Bonn, Germany, we are fully committed to achieve the objectives of the Paris Agreement. I am also pleased to hear that IPCC is publishing two other important reports this year on land and climate change and the ocean and crystal in the changing climate. It is heartening to learn that there is a dedicated chapter on high mountains in a special report on oceans and crystal on climate change, and that ISMOD and partners have made good contribution to this chapter and the overall report. I do believe that these reports will provide policy remarks, policy makers with the solid ground and the science to formulate climate change policies. As you know, the UNFCCC is planning a global stockable or climate change efforts in 2023, and this sixth assessment report will be published in 2022, a year before the global stock day. This will help parties develop a common time frame and reporting and implementing the Paris rule book, which was finalized in 2024. I urge all scientists who are assessing climate information, trends in climate, observed impacts, human fingerprints, and other scientific facts and figures to recommend alternative climate resilience development pathways, considering the rights of future generations to live in peace and harmony, and the sustainability of nature and human systems. Climate change being a global agenda, this is also the right time to invite regional efforts, for which your recommendations are crucial. On a central note, by the same note, presents an alarming slate of messages about the impact of climate change in the Hindu Kush Himalayan region, almost affecting a quarter of humanity. I firmly believe that mountains need a special attention in the region and global climate agenda. As a mountainous country, the government of Nepal will take the lead to force an alliance of mountain countries of the world and raise concerns in the forthcoming UN Climate Summit and COP25. I am pleased to inform this August gathering that the government of Nepal has announced a Sagarmatha dialogue, an international platform to bring together world leaders through leaders and relevant stakeholders for a discourse and cooperation on pressing issues of humankind. The first Sagarmatha dialogue will be held in 2020 in Kathmandu on the climate change theme, and I humbly invite scientists to join hands with Nepal and contribute. But as this Sagarmatha dialogue will be organized in March, we have tentatively thinking to organize the program on Mars, but formally it is not decided yet. And all of you, all the friends are invited, all the scientists are invited and contribute in that Sagarmatha is particularly organized for the issue of climate change. I believe that your assessment will help us in developing our common stand and explore collective efforts to combat the climate crisis. Distinguished scientists, countries have different geoclimatic situations and varying levels of climate change, mitigation and adaptation capacity. Climate change has unequal impacts in an unequal world. We know that some of the countries are in a better position in terms of preparedness, while others need external support. It is also a fact that least developed countries like Nepal are the most vulnerable. Therefore, I urge scientists to keep these countries in mind while assessing the facts and writing the report and making appropriate recommendations. Particularly the small island countries are in danger because of the climate change and global warming. The sea level is increasing. And mountainous countries are related to this question. And particularly I would like to draw your attention that two-thirds of the Himalayan range lies in Nepal. Two-thirds of the Himalayan range. And the waters in the gullies, in the wet season, in the rainy season, 40% we contribute, because the catchment area of India is larger and it contributes 60% in the rainy season. But in dry season, we contribute 72% of the water of Ganga. It clearly indicates that the importance of the Himalayas, the ice, we and our mountains are shouldering. And recharge system we are contributing through our mountains. And naturally, this is contribution of Nepal, naturally, not by made by anybody, but naturally it is our contribution. And second contribution, I want to just draw your attention. This mountain region is between the lines of Cancer and line of Capricorn, between about. And this is the hot area. And the hot air comes from the deserts and hot areas. And when it moves to nearer to the mountains, it becomes cool. So to cool the mountains, the importance, to cool the air, hot air, and to make the temperature down, contribution of the mountains and Himalayas is very, very important. And as I mentioned, rich heart system. This is not only cold peaks, the Himalayas, but the Himalayas are the estuaries of water, resources of water. And the water doesn't rain, just doesn't rain on the top of the mountains and goes through, but it rains as the ice, it falls as the ice, snow. And the mountain shoulder, many meters, thick layer of ice, and gradually melts and drops and goes to the rocks, and they gradually release. And the earth is recharged with water. This is a process. So I would like to draw attention of the scientists that we have to make more research in this question, the importance of the mountains. So, if we want to control the flood in Tarai, or in India, or in Bangladesh, or want to control the raising above the sea level, we have to give attention on the mountains.
Very good.
Anyway, I just tried to draw your attention toward the importance of the mountains. Science is supposed to be natural, neutral. I urge you to temper that neutrality with the sense of climate justice and fairness. Finally, climate finance is a prerequisite to address the unpredictable impacts of climate change. Direct and easy access to resources and technologies will be crucial for least developed countries to prepare for and address climate change challenges. A twofold strategy of South-South cooperation and North-South cooperation needs to be adopted in favor of the most vulnerable countries. In closing, I wish you all a very pleasant stay in Nepal and wish you every success in preparations of the 6th assessment report of the IPCC. Thank you for your presence. Thank you very much.